Hello everybody and welcome back once again to Running Red. Today I was going to show you this one. Well, let's do it first of all and you can see what I'm talking about. In fact, I better turn off my jetpack. Lean over here and press this button. If I'm not in the right place, I'll try again. Oh, and look where I am. About the bee island where we put the bees before. And if I come back and do the same thing again, I should be back home. Cool. Now, this is a Teleposer. And how do we make a Teleposer? Let's have a look. It's this thing here. Or rather, teleporters, but those aren't. That's a mechanism and that's a mechanism. And this is the blood magic one. So it's a relatively straightforward recipe, except for this teleposition focus. 3 gold, 2 ender pearls. And you need 2. You need a pair, of course. But this is quite easy now. You've got 1 ender pearl and a tier 4 altar with 2000 LP gives you a teleposition focus. Let's go and make one of those. I've already got one made, so as well to make one of these. So let's come up here. Yes, I need tier 4, don't I? Let's put that in the altar and take out the master of the door. I'll get this right this time. And we wait a few seconds. And it actually goes quite quickly, this one. If we look at the divination, so you can see it's already gone. I'll leave that in it. It'll do something else. So the first thing you have to do with this thing is actually bind it to your network. So let's bind it to my network. That's it. Right click it. Let's have a look. Let's press E and now see. So now it's our current owner and the coordinates is 000. So let's have a look at this. I have, I think somewhere, one of these already made. Trouble is I've forgotten where I put it. That was clever, wasn't it? Well, not in there. Maybe, yes, here we are, in this chest. And this one, as you may notice, is already bound. You see, imbued with blood, actually that's a 01, and the other one is bound here. The coordinates, 290, 70, and 283, in dimension minus 1. Now, actually, that's the nether. If you look at this one over here, I think I need an open hand to do that. Let's have a look at that. Right click it. See, this one is actually bound to those coordinates, which is where the little blood island, the bee island was, where I got the bees from. So let's put the next one down here. I need to put it a little bit further back, don't I? Where should we put it? Let's put it here. It costs a bit to transport, but not that much. So let's put that down there. And in it now we put this one. Put that in there, and then let's take this one, because this is currently... I must have clicked that one. Or did I take it out of here? I think I took it out of here, didn't I? Oh no. I think I've clicked this one. I'll do it again. Click it on this one here. Right click it on that. So now we check it again. So that's its location, which I reckon is probably correct. If we have a look at the map, let's go actually stand on this and have a look at the map. So minus 4562, let's have a look, compare that to the map. Yes, that's the right place. So now we have another teleposer. I think I've got one set up in the nether already. So what we also need is a redstone signal. The redstone signal is the thing that activates it. So what we need for redstone signal is a button. I'll make a couple because I can't remember if I've already made them. It's fairly cheap, so no big deal. So let's first of all put this button on here. Let's shift right click it. Let's stand on here and right click it. And I hope that actually before I do that, I will just do one thing. I will put away anything that's really valuable. Magician put up's reasonably okay. This one's reasonably hard work to make. And the rest is okay. So I'll take the bound blade and put the dagger of sacrifice up there. That'll still do. Now let's have a look. Let's keep your fingers crossed. It's obviously the first time I've done this. Oh, nothing happened. Let me double check that. It is owned, it is in the right dimension. So I should have moved there. In fact, I think we'll have to go and see what's actually going on. Before I go, arrows got plenty good. I was hoping to actually to be able to jump there. That's the way. And what I've also been doing here is I've been building myself a little obsidian cave, if that's the right word. It's not really a cave, it's a room. And the idea is I'm going to put in the wither skeleton in a spawner and spawn it. So before I need to do that, there's a few more things I need to do. One of them is to make some way of getting energy here. So I reckon the best way for that is going to be, can't remember, let's have a quick look. I forgot what I wanted to build. Let's have a look. What will it be now? It will be, I think it is, it's something to do with, let's have a look. I want that one. Let's have a look at the usage of that one. Oops. Click that. And have a look at the usages of it. Right click. So Enderium blend is used in a ingots, and they're used in, I have forgotten what I want to make. A tesseract, exactly. So I need to make a tesseract frame. Well, that was bad. Chance of forgetting a tesseract. Anyway, I want to be able to transfer energy and essence, I think it's called essence, into the spawner. So obviously the spawner will produce, I need a spawner and a grinder. So the grinder will actually have some essence in it, producing, but it never produces enough. So we have to give it a bit of extra. And I think with a tesseract I can transfer both energy and fluids into there. Obviously transfer items out again. So look, it's now just about painting itself in. And here I have this one, and I do not know why this one didn't work. Maybe it's because it needs this in here. It's a bit high up as well. I'll probably have to put a button on that. And can I get, oh, I've got a button already. So this was the room I've been building. It's not finished yet. I ran out of obsidian when I was here, so I probably should have brought some more back. So can I get onto this? Let's press F to enable the jetpack. Yes I can. Let's turn the jetpack off F and see if this works. No. That's a shame. Maybe you can only teleport within. That was interesting, Sam. Slightly different. Shame. I was hoping to be able to teleport between dimensions. But I'm sure you can. I must have got something wrong. So anyway, way back to the long walk. Maybe I should put one at the gateway here, then it would work, and I would save myself all this walking. And those random sounds you hear, the ones I was talking about, the ambient sounds, they're just there to spook you. So if you've never seen them, you must have heard them, they make sort of strange noises. And they usually do it at lower light levels, so come sort of evening time, I suppose. But they are random, they don't mean anything particular. I wonder. Actually, there are other focuses. Maybe I need to change the focus. If I leave that focus in there, a second one, it will actually get to a different level. Maybe I need that to go through the dimensions. Let's try that. That's weird, isn't it? I'll show you what I mean. So we need a couple of ender pearls, and we'll leave those in a little bit longer this time. Unfortunately, I don't have one set up, but we shall see. So let's put those in there. Take this out of here and put it back in again. Now you see, it will change first of all to a telefocus, and then it'll change again. I think what I was watching before was a... You see, now it's already these are focuses. If I leave it a little bit longer, they start again, and they go to another level. And I actually, to be honest with you, I don't know what level we need to do. Maybe it has to go to a third level. I wonder if there are any enderpearls around here while this is cooking. There you go. Now, it's got some rotting flesh. So this time I've now got an enhanced teleposer. It doesn't tell you what it's going to be used for, but we'll try that one. Get out of the way of the noisy mobs. In fact, while I'm here, I'm going to just take my jetpack off. It's down to 60% and charge it up. It won't take too long. As you may notice now, the blood is flowing. This tank I could hardly keep full, and now is completely full, and it's been like that for since I did this. So let's go back in here, and we want to just take one. Oh, we need to bind these to myself, don't I, first of all? So let's just bind that to myself, right click it in the air, and do the same with this one. It has to be bound to your network, that's the important thing. So they're actually owned. Now we can right click one of these on here and take that one out. In fact, we could quite quickly build another teleposer, couldn't we? So it was 6 gold, because we don't have any shortage of enderpearls, and the telefocus. I need one of those. Let's just put that in there and make another one of these quickly. We probably don't need the enhanced one. This is actually, it's using LP for the, I'm not sure it's using LP for, actually I thought it was, I'd be using it for the grinder, of course, yes. A well of suffering. So now we have one of those. All this walking around. So we just put that one in the middle of this, and then we should get a teleposer. So we can now go to the, let's come here, this one, and take out the current one of these, because that's actually set to the right dimension. Let's just try this. Hopefully this time it works. Close the gate. Don't want any zombie penguin walking around. Right, now I can put one of these teleposers, this one, I can put it down here. Let's put it down, say, here. Okay, and then we need to put on, I don't have a switch when we do, that was clever. I have to give it a redstone signal. I got a lever. Now I think, yes, I can put the lever on the side, cool. that I left my jetpack behind. I better go and get that, hadn't I? Because I can't get up to that. I'll leave the gate open for the time being, because it won't be very long. Oops, gone past my jetpack already. It's not fully charged, but it'll probably be charged enough. It is. Put that on quickly, because I do need to be able to fly. Just to get onto the top of the Teleposer. Brilliant, huh? There we go. Now, with a bit of luck, this should send me to the other one. Oh, turn my jetpack off. There we go. That works. So that works between dimensions anyway, within the same dimension. So let's just try. Now we've got this one here. This is the one we want. Let's take this one out of here and put this one in. Take this one here now. This is the one that's not currently positioned. Right click it on there. So now it's now positioned correctly. Let's see if we can turn the jetpack on, I guess. 1.5 blocks is too far to jump. Turn the jetpack off and let's press the button, see if it works. No. Okay. It was a good try, but didn't work. Bane. Now the problem is, I can't get back to the other one because I didn't make a second. That was clever, wasn't it? Maybe I have to do this one more level. I think there's more than one level of these as well. Let's have a look. Let's see if there's a usage of this one, or we can find a usage. The reinforced, a stronger version of them. Maybe that's what I need to do. And this one, there might be another one as well, which would be a demonic transportation focus, stronger version of the focus. I think this is for doing a lot more than what we're doing. And I don't want to go and get another thing at the moment. What a pain. Sure, so it was careless. It wasn't actually, I made two of those. Never mind. Let's go the fast way. That's simply right clicking the. Okay, well, we know that one works for that place. So let's go back home. What I'll do is I'll start. I won't try that again until I've actually checked it works. Oops, two gates. But what I want to do, another thing I would like to do in this episode anyway, is to automate the this thing, because it's a pain. Let's take it, let's pick it up. And what I need to automate it is something in here. Well, I think it's the weak activation crystal I need, but it's not such a problem. And the this is the one I need, the Ballad of Alchemy. Let's see if this works. What I've got is I've already prepared it, but I didn't get it to work. So here we have a master ritual stone, which we always need for everything we build, and an altar. What we do is put the master ritual stone in the middle, as usual. And then we select the ritual diviner. And let's put in here the 16 stones so we can see it doing its business. We shall stand on it as well, because there we go. And this is now semi-automated. We have to do one more thing. We have to put the altar on top of it, and we have to put the alchemy set here in front of it. And on top of that, we want to put the altar. So let's get the altar out here. Okay. Now, what is supposed to happen? Let's put a blood orb in it. I wonder. I need to do something with this, don't I? Let's go and find something we can make. I suppose the easiest thing is a simple catalyst, where you need some redstone, some glowstone, gunpowder. I think we need one of those, two of these. Gunpowder was over. Oh, I've got some gunpowder. What was the other thing we need? It should be in here. It might be a gold nugget, actually. Let me just double check it, because I've got quite a few of those made up here. Simple catalysts. Let's just check the recipe. So it's two of those. It was a sugar. And sugar, I don't have in there at the moment. But I do need the simple catalyst as well, so let's just go and get some of this. As you can see, this thing has just gone crazy. Everything is full everywhere, and in the sludge boiler is busy making lots and lots of stuff. It's just too much to cope with. I can't cope with it at the moment. And we needed sugar, don't we? So do one of those. But we also need the product, so we have to make one of these. Well, got 37, so that's fine. So what you do here is you put into one of these chests, it doesn't matter which one, on the side, the ingredients. What was the fifth one? Gunpowder. Okay. And in the altar, so the two side ones here are inputs, and the output is the one opposite the alchemist chemistry set. And all we now do is, if I blew this is correct, I've got it right, I put this in the altar here. And then it should simply make, I wonder, no, that's correct. It should make this. We've got everything I need. Two redstone, one glowstone, one sugar, and gunpowder. That was correct, I'm sure. Maybe it doesn't work with that particular orb. Let me just check the catalyst again. Yes, I can use the master blood orb, no problem. So I do not know why this is not working. Ah, I do know why this is not working. I've been a dick. I've forgotten to activate it, haven't I? Let's just, weak blood sure should do the trick. There we go, I think that's it. We should see. Has it gone? No. Did I get the thing? That's the next thing. Oh, I think I used the wrong one. Try again. Yes, now it's worked. Now I've actually activated the thing. So did I put the blood orb? No, I didn't put the blood orb in there. So that should then smoke, and it should process. And then the output should come in this chest here. Voila. Success. Well, I've been, but it's not one of my best days today, is it? I think I maybe. It works anyway. So if I want to make more at any time, I just come along and put whatever I want in here, in the ingredients in here, and it just processes a lot. Phew, that's hard work. Now, I've still got a little bit of time left, so let's see about making the tesseract, or at least starting the tesseract. The thing I need the tesseract frame, which is I need Enderium blend. So I need the tesseract frame first of all. So I need Enderium blend, which is pyrithium dusk and Enderium blend makes ingots, and this is made with shiny metal, pulverized shiny metal, and tin, and a resident ender. So the first thing we do need to do is to do a magna crucible. Have I built a magna crucible yet? I did something at the back here. Yes, I built this metallurgic infuser by mechanism. That was to produce an energy cell. So let's make, first of all, I think it's in here. So we need to make magna crucible. To melt the stuff, let's have a look. We have everything we need. Oh, that's a shrock. And a fluid transposer. This one. And we go over here and you fill that as well. Fantastic, huh? So all we need to do now with these two is put them down here. We need some ender pearls, of course. I think I will put them here. Actually, I want to put it here, the other one. I don't want it too near that thing. Let's press F7, because we're bound to have a dark patch now. Yes, we do. And I think the torch here will be fine. So, this is the fluid transposer. Let's just press Shift to close all the sides for inputs, and the same for this one, the magnet crucible. In fact, this is a good output. And that will then come into here, so we will probably want that as an input. So the first thing we need to do is to make some ender pearls. To take those, I've got 14 in here, which is, I think, plenty. We should do the whole lot. I have more. So in the magnetic crystal, we put the ender pearls. You see the power's coming in reasonably quickly. And then they should get melted. And here we go. And then those come into here, and we need a bucket, or a couple of buckets. I'm not sure how many we need. A lot of magma going on at the back there. How many buckets have I got in here, if any? I always have a bucket problem. 13. Okay, we'll take these 13 buckets and we'll put those in the fluid transposer, because there's bound to be something in here now. Yes, there is, look. And this is set to, I think this is set so it will fill it. Toggle empty. I think that's actually, it says toggle empty, I think that means it will fill it. But it has to get enough ender in here before it, I think that's one bucket, so we need a little bit more. Is that finished? No. That was 14, that's done 4. I think 4 is a bucket's worth. So we'll look. Yes, and here we have now a bucket of resident ender. Shiny metal. That is quite a simple one as well. It's also another altar job. Let's have a look. So we need a shiny ingot. And we get a shiny ingot by putting into the blood altar a lead ingot. We need tier 3 and it needs a 10,000 LP. Right. So we'll take a couple of lead ingots. I've got a couple here. And we'll go and put those in this altar up here. Let's put those in here. Take out the Master Blood Orb again. Put the Master Blood Orb back in again. And we shall wait. This is quite a slow recipe, I think. If I look at that recipe again, E for this one. It takes 1 LP per tick. And we need 10,000. So I need 20,000. It's speeded up, but it's still going to take quite a long time. So what we need to do, I've already prepared a couple anyway, doing exactly that. And I've also prepared, oops, look at this. I didn't see that before. Oh. Oh my goodness. Well, something disappeared from in here. Oh, I know what's happened. I've teleported those blocks with that teleposer. Oh dear. That's interesting, isn't it? So it didn't teleport. Oh, I don't know what happened to them. Must admit, it just was moved them somewhere. I wonder where it moved them to. Anyway, we'll find out another time. Oh my goodness. Right, here we are. I've also got some pyrethium dust and some shiny ingots. The pyrethium dust will come to in a minute. Let's go and pulverize these shiny ingots to start with. Probably better do it in here, hadn't I? Take out the aluminium dust and put the aluminium ores back in here. And find a place for the aluminium dust. I think here's probably still got some space, amazingly. See, and I'm actually getting, oh yes, it's done the four shiny ingots. So now we need some tin, which we should have plenty of tin in here. So we'll need, I think it's 3, so we need 12 of those. So let's assemble that together. So it's basically one of them and a bucket of that will give me Enderium blend. Fantastic, look at that. So we're now going to get another bucket. We should have another 2 buckets of resident ender, I think. Yes, we'll get another bucket out of there, no problem. If I can ever get past my machines. Eight. And we'll get the third bucket and do the third one. Because it doesn't do too much harm having a little bit of an extra Enderium blend. So there's 2 buckets in there, I just need 2 ender pearls and that would make the fourth bucket. Let's take that out of there and these out of here. Now, the pyrethium dust was made by, let's have a look at the recipe for that. Fairly straightforward, blaze powder and pulverized coal, no big deal, but this is the hard one. How do we get sulfur? So let's have a look here. I was trying to spell it right there, of course I have difficulty. Sulfur, right. So then an F. I think it's a thermal expansion one I use. If I pulverize coal, I will get a 10% chance of sulfur. I can use an induction smelter on soil sand and netherrack and have a 25% of sulfur. That's probably good. That's probably a good one actually. That seems to be reasonable. And again, pulverizing. So that, I think I did it using pulverizing coal. But let's just go and get some. Probably need some more. So that was netherrack and soul sand, and we should have in the right chest it is, which is here. We've got 6 of these, I needed 2, didn't I? That'll give me 3 and 3 of those. I think that was the order. So we, one of those, we should stand the chance of getting 1 at least. This is the induction smelter, so I think it doesn't matter which way around we're doing. So we should get some nether bricks. Oh, so I don't have enough netherrack for the second one, and I didn't get any coal. I used 4 for 1. Okay, I didn't read the recipe very carefully. So we need some more netherrack. Well, I suppose that's fairly straightforward. Let's just get some string, and I have plenty of string over here. In fact, I won't do that today because I've already got pyrethium dust and I'm running out of time. In terms of, I don't want to make the episode too long, it gets a bit boring. And I think this time I made a bit of a. So I need an induction smelter for these two, and then we should get some Enderium ingots. So back to the induction smelter, let's take these out of here. Let's put these in here and let's see what happens. Fantastic, look at that. So I will end up with about 12 Enderium ingots, and I think that's probably enough for a tesseract, but I need 2. Let's have a look. need 4. Yes, I need 8. Oh, yeah, we'll be alright then. I should be okay. So we fill it with, and then put ingots around it. How much do we need? 1,000. Okay, so we need a bucket. So I should be able to make 2 test racks. Okay. On that note, I'm going to say bye for now, and I'll see you next time. Hopefully I'll have figured out this teleposer, how I get to the nether, without teleposing my Aubrey farm. And until then, bye for now.